Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Today we're here with paratroopers. That's right, we're out here by Pio Pico Resort, where we're staying at the Thousand Trails, and we've got these parachutists coming down, so I thought I'd stop and do a little bit of a shot for you guys so you could check this out, because it's pretty cool. Maybe we can get one of them to say hi to us while they're coming down. It could happen, guys. So I want to know, have any of you guys actually ever parachuted like this before? I never have. I've thought about it, but I'm kind of chicken when it comes to heights. But I got to give these guys credits, man. We've been watching them come from the plane way up there all the way down here, and it's been pretty cool. I wish I could show you them jumping out of the plane, but it's a little bit too high and you just couldn't see it. But pretty neat watching these guys come down right here.
Oh, he was got a tandem set up. Oh, it's a wing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you guys know, I often find very interesting people to have a little chat with. And we have Carolina with me. And she just jumped out of the sky. You saw her land just a moment ago, back to Earth. Carolina, you got to tell my viewers out there what it feels like to jump out of an airplane. What kind of rush do you get from that?
I don't think we do it for the rush much. We do it for the flying part of it. Uh-huh. We get to fly our own bodies. We have our own wings, as you can see right here. Mm-hmm. So I'll go for that. I'll go more for the flying than the adrenaline.
Wow, yeah, that must be incredible. So how high do you go before you jump out of the plane?
We usually go to 13,000 feet.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
It's about a whole minute of flying before we open this.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so do you fly basically right over the airfield here?
Yes, we do. We want to fly as close as we can so we can land where we want.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, we jump right over the airfield, and then we fly a little pattern that we do, and then we land right here.
And about how long have you been doing this?
About 3 years.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Was it scary the first time you did it?
It was.
Yeah.
Yes.
But you get over that quickly?
You like it so much that you learn how to get over it.
Well, great. Is there any way that people might be able to get a hold of somebody here if they're interested in doing what you're doing?
Definitely. It's skydivesandiego.com.
There it is, guys. I do appreciate your interview today.
No problem.
Thank you so much.
No worries.
Kristy and I were out on one of our toad adventures when we spotted some of these guys falling from the sky. So we thought we'd go and take a look at it. I'm glad we did, because it was quite an interesting adventure. We ended up meeting a few of the skydivers. We met one of the instructors and a few military people along the way. And that was cool, but I gotta say, it just wasn't quite weird enough for me. We had to go one step further and find something quite a bit stranger. We headed off in Zombie Toad once again to a small town called El Cajon, where there's an interesting place called the Unarians Academy of Science. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have warped here to the Unarians Academy of Science, and we're going to check this out a little bit, see what it's all about. They got a great mural back here, a little bit of airbrush work. Looks pretty cool. Very interesting with the spacecraft and such. Let's go inside and take a look, shall we? All right, Billy, go ahead and tell our folks out there in YouTube land what it is that your goal is here. What are you trying to tell people? What are you trying to show people in having your museum here?
Well, it's not just a museum. It's a school. It's a spiritual school, interdimensional. And it runs from the seventh dimension. Our teachers are from the seventh dimension down through into the fourth dimensional planes. And they're teaching us here how to actually how we can heal ourselves of everything by going into our past lifetimes and finding where the real cause was and take personal responsibility for what we've done or what has been done to us in other lifetimes. Say you have a sword thrust through your middle, you're going to have a cancer there in other lifetimes. And so might the person that did it to you. The thing is that we as people are hooked up to like a computer. Our psychic anatomy is our fourth-dimensional counterpart to this physical body. That psychic anatomy records everything you've ever done or seen or learned in your whole evolution since you became that first spark of the infinite. And so you're recording everything there. And how this works is you tune in to whatever it is you're seeing, what you're hearing, whoever it is you're talking to, can tune you in to something from your past lifetimes. And when that happens, you can all of a sudden, say, have a headache or something will go wrong in your life all of a sudden because of that tune-in. And your psychic, you have three parts to your psychic. You have a subconscious, which is built up from the time you're a baby in this lifetime through that whole lifetime. That's your subconscious. And your psychic has a mental conscious, which is everything that you've ever learned. So first you tune into your subconscious, and then it goes into that mental consciousness. And you're just like that computer or a television station where you have the receiver and the sender, and it's all done in a psychic way. You don't realize it, but your brain doesn't think. Your psychic anatomy does the thing. That mental part of yourself works that brings in past life knowledge that you've already learned. Also, every time you work out a past life, you actually go into polarizing that information with your higher self. And every time you do that, your higher self gets stronger and your lower self gets weaker. And we have both. We have good lifetimes, we have bad lifetimes. And everybody has learned what they know now by going through evolution and going through those lifetimes. And you build up each time, hopefully, better and better, and you get more information. And you learn by doing that. That's how the infinite creator created us. That's the way we learn and grow. And eventually, you keep doing that until you have no negativity left in your psychic anatomy. Then you're not on this world anymore. When you pass away, what happens is you go over, and then you can stay there. But we all have a base plane frequency that we vibrate on, and each person has that. The worlds have it. Everything has a base plane frequency that we vibrate on. And so that frequency will not allow you to stay into the astral world any longer than a certain length of time. You have to keep coming back. You'll automatically come back into another physical body. And the object being to work out all of that negative karma you've created for yourself. And we keep repeating the same thing over and over and over again. Because we don't have this knowledge. A lot of people don't even know they've lived many lifetimes, let alone the fact that what you do yesterday determines your today. And I mean lifetimes, not days. You know, it creates your past creates your future. I mean, this lifetime, what you're doing now for yourself is what your future is going to be in another lifetime. Whether you think of your spirituality, learn about yourself, help others, be creatively open, all of those things do you well, you know, in another lifetime, because you will have a step up in your frequency.